In this screencast, we're going to use osmotic shock as a method of disrupting cells. In this problem statement, we're giving information about the concentration of salt required to disrupt cells using osmotic shock and osmotic pressure, and the concentration of salt actually contained within the cells themselves. It's determined at some point that to improve downstream processing, we'd like to change the use of salt that we're using. We want to use something like magnesium chloride instead of the sodium chloride. And what we'd like to do is estimate the concentration of magnesium chloride needed to effectively lyse these cells. The first question we'd ask is, why would these two salts behave differently in an osmotic shock type process where we're trying to lyse cells? To do that, we'd want to understand what's the governing relationship that drives osmotic pressure, this transmembrane pressure that would be established on the basis of different concentrations of salt inside and outside of the cell. And we'd use the Van't Hoff law to relate those. Now, the Van't Hoff law just very simply relates osmotic pressure with the temperature that exists, the concentration of salt particles or the concentration of particles that are inside the particular membrane or inside the cell, and the concentration of particles that are on the outside. A couple things to note about this law is temperature is an absolute temperature, so we're going to have to convert that to Kelvin. And also, again, these concentrations aren't molarity, as we're dealing with osmolarity or the particle concentration both inside and out. So for that, we'd actually have to calculate something along the lines of osmolarity, which is covered in a separate screencast. Now, this Van't Hoff law is entirely governed by this concentration change of particles in solution. So if we think about what's currently being used in the disruptor, we have sodium chloride, which dissociates into one sodium and one chloride, giving us 2 moles of particles. And now we're going to use magnesium chloride, which is actually going to go from 1 mole of magnesium chloride into 3 moles of particles. So 1 mole of magnesium and 2 moles of chloride. So the fact that these two compounds break into different moles of particles in solution means we're going to be changing this overall driving force for osmotic pressure. So when we calculate the number of moles for magnesium chloride, that's fundamentally going to have to be different than the number of moles that we originally were using for sodium chloride. So our overall approach in this problem is going to be first to determine the osmotic pressure that's currently being exerted across this system to disrupt the cells using sodium chloride. And then we're going to come back and calculate using that osmotic pressure what concentration change we would need in magnesium chloride to exert that same osmotic pressure across that membrane to give us that same osmotic shock to lyse the cells. So here we've begun to calculate the actual osmotic pressure required to lyse these cells. So I've denoted that with a pi sub r, the required osmotic pressure. Started to fill in using the gas constant and also the absolute temperature, since we're given a temperature 25°C. And now we need to determine the concentration of particles both inside and outside of the cell. So inside the cell, we're given information that the cells have a salt concentration that's very similar to what we would actually see, or an osmotic pressure similar to what we'd see for 0.1 molar sodium chloride. So to calculate the moles of particles, we would just take what we're given in terms of 0.1 molar sodium chloride, and then we'd take that into the number of particles that distributes into upon solvation, and we get 2 moles of particles per mole of sodium chloride. And we can calculate both inside and using the concentration we're given for the concentration of salt required outside, we can again do that conversion to determine the osmolarity on the outside. And quickly calculating through, we can see the osmotic pressure required is 446 kPa. And if we look at our units, we see inside we have moles canceling with moles, liters canceling with liters, and we end up with Kelvin canceling with Kelvin, and we end up with units of kilopascals, which is a pressure, as we would expect. So now that we know the osmotic pressure required to lyse these cells, now we need to go through and calculate a new external concentration of particles and calculate what that would need to be for magnesium chloride and convert that to a molarity. So here we know our osmotic pressure needs to be at least 446 kPa to lyse the cells. So we can plug that into our Van't Hoff relationship, incorporate information on the gas constant and also the temperature of the system. And then we need to incorporate the information on the osmotic driving force for this system. So we know the concentration of salt particles inside is the same as we've calculated before. So I'm going to bring that information from the previous calculation. And we're going to subtract from that the new concentration of salt particles that are on the outside of the cell. And just quickly doing the math, we determine that our new concentration of particles on the outside of the cell is going to be 0.02 moles per liter. And then taking the information we have before about 1 mole of magnesium chloride turning into 3 moles of magnesium and chloride ions, we can then do the conversion from moles of particles per liter into just moles per liter of magnesium chloride. And quickly doing that conversion, we can determine with that 3-to-1 conversion, we have a new concentration of magnesium chloride needs to be 0.0067 moles per liter or molar of magnesium chloride. Now, if we come back and ask the question, does this final answer make sense? We can then compare it to what we started out with. We know that 0.01 molar sodium chloride actually does disrupt the cells. And we actually have, for every mole of magnesium chloride, we actually have more ions or more particles that are formed in solution. So we should require less magnesium chloride. If we wanted to sort of mentally do the math, we realize that for magnesium chloride, we get 3 ions per mole, and sodium chloride gives us 2 ions per mole. We can then go back and briefly check, say that we should need roughly 2/3 of the amount of magnesium chloride to actually give us the same osmotic pressure. And in fact, that is exactly what we find.